What is up, everybody? Welcome back. This is the last live stream for me for 2018. Later today, I am getting on a real plane and flying back to the United States to my hometown of Atlanta, Georgia, which is what we are doing today. I have an American 737, and we're going to fly to Atlanta, Georgia, currently in Cincinnati, Northern Kentucky, KCGB, at 7 a.m. Let me just make sure our sound is okay here. We'll get in the cockpit and get started. And my aviation flashlight. Go up top. Get our power going. Connect to ground power, which I've already got on. Arm our emergency lights. Fasten seatbelts on auto. Turn on the tail logo. And get the nav lights on. Hydraulic pressure. We'll go ahead and turn on a dome light because there's not a lot of ambient light. Get rid of this. Start getting our IRS systems aligned. I'll come down here and do position initialization. KCVG. Copy that in the scratch pad and enter it on our IRS position, and we are good. Alright, start doing some checklists. Preliminary, battery switch, guard is closed, we're on GPU, IRS mode, on nav, voice recorder, don't care, go ahead and close the flight deck door. Emergency equipment, go check the ELT light, it is extinguished and armed. GPS, got the hydraulics on, interphone, don't care, engine panel is set. Oxygen, we'll go ahead and make sure it's on auto, and we'll finish setting that later. Oops. Landing gear lights 3 and 3. Flight recorder stall warning test. Gear extension door is that aviation flashlight again. It is closed. And our parking brake is set. So let's go ahead and tune the radios and get the weather here. KCGV ATIS frequency is 134.375. Actually, I'm gonna go put Atlanta in first. I know that's 119.650. Because that is my hometown. Got it memorized. Put that in for arrival. And then get KCGB 134.375. Now let's try the other one. Departure is 135.3.
Cincinnati INTL Information Quebec. 1100 Zulu weather. Wind 190 at 6, visibility more than 10. Sky conditions 20,000 few, temperature 4, dew point minus 1. Altimeter 2994. Arriving runways 18 right, 18 center, 18 left, departing runways 18 right, 18 center, 18 left. Advise on initial contact, you have Quebec.
Alright, we have information Quebec, winds 190 at 6, departing runways, we're going to take 18 center, that's about, it's at our 9 o'clock there, double check, but that should be 18 center. I can't read the numbers, but I'm fairly sure that's what it is. So put that at 18 center. Down here to our FMC and get started on this. KCGV is the origin. We're going to Kilo Alpha Tango Lima. Hartsfield-Jackson. Flight number, we are American Airlines. Don't know, let's see what the tail number is. 980. We'll just plug that in. Here we go. Sorry, departure is KCGV. Our 18 center. Departure is going to be Kenlin 4. There we go. Transition HYK. Go ahead and put that in. Come down to our flight plan from our transition. We're going direct to Katarin. Kilo Tango Romeo Yankee. November. And then we'll start the arrival. That was easy. Winds in Atlanta. Let's see what the weather is doing real quick. Winds 220, 4 knots. 10 miles of visibility, scattered clouds at 20,000, broken at 25,000. Temperature 7, dew point is -2. Altimeter 3020. So I'm expecting 27 right. Go to Atlanta. Our arrival is Peachy 1. We're going to go 27 right. Take the ILS. Do we have a transition? Yeah, kept that one. I'm going to put this in there and see what that looks like. Usually when you put a transition here on the approach, you'll get a longer approach course. I'll just find it's more time to get everything set up and stabilized. So we'll try this one. If it doesn't look right, we'll delete it. Route, activate, execute. Let's see if we can have a look at that yet. Guess we'll have to wait for the IRS to align. Go ahead and put our performance weight and stuff. Let's see what that's supposed to be. Our zero fuel weight needs to be 132,444. So let's go ahead and put zero in here and see what we need to add. 132.4 minus, what is that? 91.3. Payload needs to be 41,100. 132.4, perfect. And block fuel, 14,900 pounds, 904. I'm going to round up to the nearest 100. So we'll go 15,000. Oops. 15,000 pounds. Actually, there you go. Center of gravity should be okay. And no fuel in the center tank. So, now we got our IRS aligned, so we can go ahead and step through our plan and see what that looks like. 18 center. Oh, this is interesting. So, obviously I'm from Atlanta. And one of my friend's fathers worked as an air traffic controller at Hartsfield for decades. He just retired recently. Their family name is Smelley. This waypoint is actually named after their family. So every time I do an arrival through Beachy 1 and I go over Smelley, I think of those people. True story. So here's the transition that we put in there, UU. So it'll be above 7,000 and we'll have a really long approach to 27. And we'll be able to intercept the ILS there at Mercer, below 4,000 feet, which is great. That looks good to me. There are no discontinuities. Let me double check. That is a good flight plan, y'all. I'll take it. Go ahead and get our performance numbers in. There we go. Planned fuel reserve. Fuel for today is 6.9. My favorite number, terrible cost index, 11. It's going to take us forever. Flight level is going to be 340. And top of cruise winds, 270 at 9.1. So we might get a good bit of chop if it's coming off of our 3 o'clock. 270 at 9.1. What is our isot deviation? Zero. go. Transaltitude in the United States, 18,000. So let's go ahead and look at our N1 limits. Outside temperatures, 4 degrees. Let's have a look. 18 center is a really long. We'll derate 11,000 feet runway. Takeoff, do flaps 5. Get our center of gravity, and trim is going to be 4.8, which we can go ahead and get on. Start loading and cleaning. Let's get the runway winds.
Cincinnati INTL Information, Quebec.
1906. Dry conditions, outside temperature we got. Go back, get our V speeds on 40, 41. And 49. Go ahead and execute that. Make sure that we're on the same page here. Performance. And I'll go ahead and put in our minimums for 27 right. 200 feet for Class C. Yes. Do radio minimums. We've got 200 feet. And we'll go ahead and set up our MCP. So our V2 speed is 149. Runway heading is 186. No ATC, going straight to 34,000. Doing GPS, so I'm turning the VOR. Radio's off here. I will set the course for 275, which is, I think, the final runway heading. Double check that. Yep, 275. Arm the flight directors, arm the auto throttle, VNAV and LNAV engage, which means that the FMC is properly set, which is good. Go ahead and do our oxygen panel. Landing altitude is 860. Atlanta is 1,030, so 934,000. Looking good. We have hydraulic pressure, so we'll go ahead and turn the yaw dampers on, and we can start our window heat. And I'll set this up so when we turn on the APU, we'll get pressures. Turn the packs to auto, isolation valve to auto, turn the bleed for the APU on, and the engine bleeds off. Let's do a quick once over here, make sure everything looks all right. Still a little dark outside. All right. Stop the loading. Start our leg here. Before we start the APU and get people boarding, let's do this. Put in transponder code, if I'm not doing ACC, I always do 4702, which is almost always what the X-Plane standard, or what the automated ATC gives you. And we'll do a fire test for the APU engines. And one more for cargo. We're good. Let's come up here and we'll go ahead and get the APU going. Turn on the left aft pump. Turn on. Wait a second to get the oil pressure going here. And click and hold. There we go. We hear it starting up. See the heat mirage coming out of the APU exhaust. That is neat. And while we're waiting for that to come on to the electrical generator bus, we'll go ahead and plan our pushback.
Route to cockpit, plan acknowledged. Call me through the menu when you are ready.
Thank you, John. Put that on the map. 20 miles for departure and get this guy. It was like it on 80. That's a good distance. Alright, let's start getting people on board and we'll go back to our checklists. Flights. Reloading. Yes. Okay. Lights tests. It's good. EFIS control panel we've got set. MCP is set. Oxygen. Set clock, put that on local time set. Notice the steering guard down here is closed. We got our displays set properly. Takeoff, cabin altitude. Stabilizer out of trim, those are fine.
Guys, DeLeo's on board.
Thanks. Flight instruments and standby instruments are set. The speed brake lever is down as are the reversers. Forward thrust levers are in off position. Flap levers are not set. I'm not doing that. Parking brake's on. Start levers are on cutoff. VHF and nav radios are set. I'll tune in the ILS frequency and stuff in the air because it gives me something to do. Audio control panel is fine, seat rudder and pedals are good, seatbelt. Let's give them the old welcome speech.
Folks, welcome aboard American Airlines. We're currently in the process of wrapping up the final paperwork. We'll be on our way momentarily. It's a great pleasure to have you on board with us today. If you have any requests that will make your trip a little bit more enjoyable, please don't hesitate to ask one of your crew members. Again, welcome aboard.
APU on the bus, and we can disconnect the ground power unit and chocks. We're basically ready for pushback. I'm doing one quick look here. Battery good, ground power disconnected, landing gear, fasten seatbelts are on auto for the time being. Window heat is on, air conditioning set, pressurization mode is on auto, we're good. Auto brake. That on RTO. Projected takeoff. Hydraulics are on and checked. Speed brake down and 10. Parking brake okay. Radio good. Transponder is on standby and our code set. Rudder and aileron we don't need. FMC CD is good. Stabilizer trim is set. Flight deck doors closed. Doors are currently open. Go ahead and close all that stuff up. Alright, we're ready for pushback. Close cargo doors. Going. Call for a pushback.
Ladies and gentlemen, the boarding
gate. Ground to cockpit. Tow is driving up.
Stand by for all call.
All right, we've got everyone strapped in. Give us a ring if you need anything.
Will do, thanks.
Okay, all doors and hatches are closed, ready to connect.
Welcome aboard.
So connected and bypass pin inserted. Release parking brake.
There you go, bud.
Starting pushback, and you may start engines.
Alrighty. Get our packs off. Oops, wrong one. Packs off. Engine number two, flip it to get fuel pumps on, that might help, and flip it to ground. Watch the N2 when that gets to about 20%. Go ahead and give it some juice.
Once again, welcome aboard American Airlines. Give you 60 moments. We'd like you to direct your attention to the video screen located throughout the cabin for an important safety demonstration on our boarding system.
There you go.
Yeah.
Engine number two.
There are so many places to go in this world. So many airlines that can take you there.
So we thank you.
For making the journey with us.
Thank you.
Some slides, except those over the wings, may also be
on continuous. Man, we got engine generation, so we'll get those on the bus. We can turn off the APU. APU bleed off, turn the engine bleeds on, and packs back to auto. Turn our probe heat on. Trim air is good.
Operation complete. Set parking brake. Disconnecting tow. stand by.
Test flight controls. Generators are on, APU is off, and the bleed is off.
Tow is disconnected and bypass pin has been removed. Hand signal will be on the right. We'll see you next time and have a great flight.
Thanks, John. See you later, buddy. Probeat is on. Anti-ice will wait until a little bit after takeoff for above freezing conditions. Flaps are set. Stabilizer trim set. Flight controls are checked, and we'll hit recall. There's our hand signal. The bypass pin. Thank you, buddy. Come up here. Taxi lights. Over here. I always feel like I'm forgetting something, even with checklists. Turn those on. I think you're good. Release parking brake. No takeoff config warning, so we're good. Turn here, we're going to take Juliet down to Delta, and then we'll turn right and follow that all the way to the end of the chart. The taxi sign system works. If you look at these signs, the black square with the yellow lettering is the one that you're on. So this taxiway that we're crossing is G, and K is the one that you're going to intercept. So if we look down here and see if we can find J is the one that we are currently on, which is what we want. And we're looking for Delta. Down there. old short line, and we'll do our final before takeoff checklists. Checked. Flaps set, stabilizer trim is set, cabin is secure, MCP is set, transponder, we'll get it on TARA. Strobes. Wing lights on. And armed landing lights. Taxis can come off, runway turnoffs can come off. Dump those.
Okay, the cabin is secured. Have a good flight.
Thanks, you're coming with us. You didn't know. Let's go. Dude, who's excited? Going to Atlanta? IRL and in the sim? Go ahead and start our elapsed time.
Flaps one.
forgot about that. And while we're climbing before we hit 10,000, go ahead and get an ATIS request for ATL.
Join to earn miles for today's flight and continue earning miles with our retail and travel partners. Our Advantage Aviator MasterCard is another great way to earn miles for everyday purchases and enjoy benefits such as your first check bag free, preferred boarding, and no foreign transaction fees. Not an Aviator card member? See a flight attendant and receive an exclusive offer when you apply in flight today. Shortly, we will begin our in-flight service. We offer a selection of complimentary beverages. Wi-Fi service is available on this flight. Connect to the AA in-flight signal and open your browser. You can access AA.com free of charge.
Which I've already got in our course.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. So we're leveled to our initial cruise altitude, expecting a fairly smooth ride today. We have the seatbelt sign turned off, and while you're seated, we do ask that you keep your seatbelt fastened about you at all times in case of any kind of unexpected bumpy air. And we do thank you for flying with us on American.
Not entirely true. I am expecting a little bit of turbulence. Go ahead and switch over to standard, and I'm going to put the altimeter 301 on. 70 knot crosswind about from 4 o'clock. Expecting another 30 knots. It's going to get a little rougher.
Thank you. 1,000 to go.
about 10 miles on the top of descent. I've already programmed the MCP, an initial descent altitude, 6,000, which is the altitude that we're supposed to be at our right turn to final. Since we're not doing ATC, I'm just going to let the flight director take care of it and just monitor that, make sure we're making sure that we're staying on our vertical profile with the spoiler.
Gentlemen, as you can see, we are descending. Seatbelt sign is on. If you happen to be up and about, please return your seat. Keep your seatbelt fastened for the main flight. On behalf of the flight crew, we appreciate you being with us today. Wish you a very safe and pleasant journey to your final destination. Hope to see you back here with us soon. Thank you.
descent profile. Auto throttle is having kind of a hard time, so the programmed speed is 280 knots. So to get to 280, I guess the headwind is slowing it down. So I'm doing a very good job of maintaining that. Here's what I can do, instead of go B speed, I'll select it myself. We had 6,000 right when we make this right turn to final, so decrease the vertical speed, line it up with this green line. That'll do, pig.
Hartsfield-Jackson Atlanta INTL information Romeo. 1200 Zulu weather. Wind light and variable. Visibility more than 10. Sky conditions 20,000 scattered. 25,000 broken. Temperature 6. Dew point minus 1. Altimeter 3020. Arriving runways 27 right, 27 left, 26 right, 28, 26 left, departing runways 27 right, 27 left, 26 right, 28, 26 left. Advise on initial contact, you have Romeo.
Right, information Romeo, arriving runway, we've got 27 right, which is our selected runway, 27 right, the ILS, we've got the ILS frequency 111.3, course 275, that is programmed at 111.3, is active on both 1 and 2 nav radios, and our course is already set for 275, so basically ready. When we make our right turn to the final approach course, I can disarm the ILS, and that should take us directly to the runway. Shoutout to J.Smelley, whose family this nav point is named after. See you in a couple days, buddy. So we're well above the vertical descent profile, because I selected it myself, slowing down a bit. It's not an issue. As long as we hit around 6,000 feet by... below 250 knots. Go ahead and bring the slats out. Break once. The lever of shame. And go ahead and arm the approach after an MCAP.
Thousand to go.
Yep. Already picking up the ILS frequency. The localizer is coming in. You can see the glide slope right there and the localizer coming in on the bottom. So at 6,000 will hold the altitude and we'll arm the approach. Basically be good. Cut the localizer. Localizer is locked. Just wait on the glide slope.
Laps 40, 2500.
rev speed in. Let it trim itself out. 1,000 feet will go ahead and disappear into autopilot. I'll hand fly it.
Feet stabilized, Mr. Birch, altitude set.
Disarm the auto throttle to my airplane. Poppy lights to the right of the runway, so we're on the glide slope.
500. 400. 300 minimums.
Minimums.
Glide slope. Glide slope.
200 minimums.
Glide slope. Glide slope. Glide slope. Glide slope.
100.
Glide slope.
50. 40. 30. 20. 10.
Floated it. You can choose standard. I mean, are you talking about specific ones like these? You can move the camera around with the arrow keys as well as the comma and period key for back and forth. And then when you find one that you want, hold control, left control key, and then hit the keypad number that you want to save it to. Your APU started here. Not sure where American parks, so I'm parked down here by these Southwest boys. No problem. go. Let's have a look at that replay. See how much I floated it. Not the right runway. Go. Too much right there. guys. We'll leave it there. All you Atlanta people, I'll see you tomorrow, and everybody else here watching on Twitch, I'll see you guys in 2019, back in January, probably January 7th.